If you have been doing Android development and are trying to step up yourself into dependency injection framework, then I am pretty sure you might have heard about Hilt. And also, along with that, you would have heard about the term Dagger. From a very newbie perspective, you would be having a lot of questions. How Hilt is related to Dagger? Do you need to learn Dagger before you actually start working with Hilt? Will I miss anything or something if I directly start learning Hilt? Can I learn Dagger after I learn Hilt? You might even ask a question, what is Dagger? So we will try to answer all these questions before we get into the nitty-gritties of working with Hilt. To get started, Dagger is a dependency injection framework that was created by a company called Foursquare, and later it is being maintained by Google. And it is a dependency injection that was mainly created for Java, and Java was and is main programming language for Android development. If you still want to do Java-based Android development, then Dagger is still the framework to go for. However, since Kotlin is compatible with Java, even Dagger is compatible with Kotlin. Hilt is built on top of Dagger. It is customized for Android development. It even simplifies the dependency injection for very Android-specific requirements. And Hilt is very much compatible with Kotlin. Now, to answer a question, do I need to learn Dagger before Hilt? Answer is no. Hilt doesn't really hide Dagger as such. So when you are learning Hilt, you are actually also learning Dagger along with it. Now, to answer the question, am I missing something if I directly try to learn Hilt? Not really. I would say Hilt covers about 90% of the use cases of Android development, making it easy for the Android integration. That is the advantage of using Hilt over a Dagger. And whatever the remaining 10% is there, it is a very short learning curve. But learning Dagger on its own has a very steep learning curve. So as a developer, if your focus is just on Android development, then the recommended approach is you learn Hilt rather than trying to learn Dagger. You would be abstracted from a lot of the intricate details of the Dagger that might not be actually relevant from the Android application development point of view. So by now, I hope that you have a pretty fair idea of what is the relationship between the Dagger and Hilt and why we are going to learn dependency injection framework using Hilt. So what all things that you typically see when it comes to setting up of Hilt in Android application? Broadly speaking, you can split it into four steps. The first step is you configure the Gradle with Hilt dependencies. I'll be showing you how to do that in a moment. You declare your application class with the annotation @hilt_android_app. This is basically making sure that the application class is annotated with this particular Hilt annotation. The third step is you decide the entry point of your app, which is typically your activity or a fragment, and you use an annotation called as @androidEntryPoint. And then you start defining your dependencies. To do that, there are various annotations like provides, binds, module, Hilt view model, and many more. Right now, you don't worry what these mean, what is the usage of it, and how it actually works. We will discuss it when it comes to that. And then finally, you start injecting the dependencies using @inject annotation. So you can already see there is a pattern here. We use annotations here. And these are annotations provided by Hilt, which are Kotlin annotations. And we need some kind of a framework or a library which needs to process this annotation. That is where the very first step starts, which is to configure the Gradle with Hilt dependencies. So let's get started with a demo. This is our application codebase, and I am on the live coding branch. This is the same branch which we have been using for last couple of videos, using which we implemented the manual dependency injection. So we are going to use the same old code base of country info application. If you are not sure what this particular application is, let me quickly run this particular application and show you what it is all about. It is just loading some country specific information, and you can filter here and you can do a updation of capital, and if you do a long click, you can even delete. That's what the application is. The focus here is not on understanding the functionality of the application, but rather how do you refactor this particular code using Hilt. And right now our application uses manual dependency injection. And if you are new to how the manual dependency injection was implemented, what I suggest is you go back through a couple of videos where I explain how manual dependency injection is implemented. But right now, our focus is on doing the very first step, which is adding the Hilt Gradle dependencies. So the first thing that you will have to do is open the Gradle. There are two Gradle files. One is at the project level, and then another one, which is the outer Gradle file. So here you will have to add this particular line, the line number 8, which adds the Gradle dependency for the Hilt. And then under the app folder, there will be another build Gradle file. Here, you will have to add a couple of things. Add this particular line, line number 5, in the plugins, and you apply the Kotlin capped plugin. KAPT stands for Kotlin Annotation Processor Tool. This is the plugin that you need to process whatever the annotations that you would be using in your Hilt annotations. And you need it to generate code that is needed at the compile time. Once that is done, come down and you need to add the dependency here. These are the lines that basically add the Hilt dependencies to your project. And after that, this line, correction error types equals to true, this is needed because during the compile time, sometimes some kind of errors might crop up. And this basically helps the Gradle build to automatically correct the error types. This is nothing new. If you go to official documentation page of Hilt and look for Gradle configurations, this is exactly what you get. And I have just stuck to that. Nothing changed. Depending upon Gradle version and Kotlin version and Java version, some of these version numbers might change. So you may receive some compilation errors or conflicts because of that. But please make sure that when you are adding these configurations, you are making sure that other related configurations about Kotlin, Java, everything is taken care of and it should work. So with that, the very first step that we had put in our starting point, which is Gradle dependency configuration, is pretty much done. The next one is we have to basically mark our application class with Hilt Android application. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.